Hello, YouTube and all who inhabit it. Greetings to the Stop Motion Reviewer. Today we're going to be taking a look at the three-pack of Decepticon Impactor, Autobot Mirage, and Autobot Aragon, who is the final Power Dasher I needed for my collection. This figure set would normally retail for about $60 to $70 on Amazon, but funny story, the thing was on sale for $50, and I had a $15 promotional credit for storing my photos on Amazon Photos, so I wound up getting three deluxes for about $30. So I got one hell of a deal on this set. Starting off with Power Dasher Aragon, Aragon transforms into the exact same thing that Cog transforms into, given the fact he's a heavy remold of him. It's some kind of hardcore Cybertronian tank with six wheels and on top of two tank treads, and this thing looks hardcore as all shit. I gotta say, I actually love this as being a Cybertronian mode as opposed to G1 but slightly stylized. This thing really broke the mold of just playing it safe with G1. It really managed to become its own thing. Unfortunately, in its robot mode, it doesn't really come off as like this retro robo vibe that Zatar and Chromar had. That's why I like them so much, was because they're retro robots, but this one's just kind of... just weird for some reason. I still love him, don't get me wrong, and I'm glad I got all three of the Power Dashers, but ultimately speaking, he doesn't have that same appeal that the other ones have. That is, until you split him apart into 17,000 weapons for Impactor to use. I gotta say, the weaponizer idea is the coolest damn thing in the world as of right now, but I am dying for the modulators to come out already. I mean, Autobots that use buildings as weapons. How freaking boss is that? On top of that, base modes for Micromasters, you just can't get any better. Moving on to transformation for Aragon, it is pretty much just splitting them apart, but I do like the fact that there's a lot more to the transformation in terms of actually moving parts instead of just breaking parts apart. The other Power Dashers are pretty much Lego sets at a certain point in time, but there's at least some steps to transformation on this figure. Getting him into his robot mode, I have to say, I do like him, don't get me wrong, but he, again, just doesn't have that retro robot vibe I was looking for. I absolutely love the sculpting on the thing, though, and he does look like an entirely different character from Cog. I have to say, it's amazing what a fresh coat of paint and a different head sculpt can do for a figure. The guy does somewhat have a Diaclone vibe in his vehicle mode, but his robot mode is just awesome for the sake of it being weird and obscure. Moving on to the Hologram Mirage, I have to say that a lot of people were complaining about this thing coming off in clear plastic, but the plastic on this actually feels tighter and a lot more endurable than the retail Mirage that's actual not clear plastic. The Formula One race car mode and its clear, transparent look is actually really cool. I thought that a lot of the parts and mechanics were going to be visible from the inside of the vehicle, and that would just ruin the whole illusion of it being an invisible vehicle, but I have to say that this manages to actually conceal the fact that it's a robot really well, given the fact you can see right through it. Moving on to the exact same transformation as a retail Mirage, I have to say that this transformation is really creative and just overall bizarre. I said it was completely friggin' bonkers about 20 times in the previous review, so I'm not gonna say that again, but I am going to say that this figure's a lot like G1's Slapdash in similarities of engineering, and I dig it for that. In his robot mode, he is slightly deeply imperfect thanks to the fact that his calves protrude about 8 feet away from his body thanks to the wheel wells not being able to fold into anything, but I do actually love the look of the robot mode. It has a lot more of a Diaclone-esque head sculpt, and as a result, it looks like what would happen if Diaclone actually wound up doing some kind of mail-away exclusive. It's really cool, and it's sort of a post-Obi-Wan exclusive kind of deal that they sold back in the 80s. It has that kind of vibe to it, and I enjoy it a lot. The posability on the figure is the exact same as Mirage, so I'm not going to go over it too much, but I am actually quite amazed about the amount of sculpted detail that still manages to be somewhat visible from certain angles. Although I do feel like the fact that it's transparent manages to do away with a lot of that. We're going to take a look at Decepticon Impactor now. This is where the box set starts to fall apart for me, of course. One of the ratchet joints in his thighs is broken. Every time you buy on bulk, there's always some quality control problem or some kind of cheapened plastic or some kind of crappy compromise. Absolutely nothing changes in its tank mode. Aside from the fact you can see some tampographed on caution tape, there really is not anything different about the tank mode whatsoever. Getting him on to transformation, I will say again that the transformation on Deluxes has come so far and become so innovative and fun, it's not even funny. Don't even get me started on Voyager class figures. Every one of them seems to be an engineering masterpiece, scaled at a $30 budget. But Impactor's a really fun transformation aside from the fact that his mohawk is paper thin and you can't scrape the head out without the gun. taking a look at Impactor and his Decepticon alt mode, I have to say he does actually look a lot more cartoony than the retail individual release. He does look a lot more like a Decepticon too, just because of the head sculpt, but there is also some caution tape on his shoulders to slightly differentiate from the original. Fortunately, they're not stickers, which I'm kind of shocked by because I'm sure they were going to cheap out somehow, but this is actual painted detail with some actual sculpting incorporated in there. And I have to say, the sculpting on all three of these figures is awesome, although on Mirage, again, there's no point because it's supposed to be invisible. Anyways, all rant aside, I would say, is a 3-pack worth it? Kind of. If you're willing to get this thing off Amazon, it is about $50 on sale right now, and I managed to get mine for only about $32 to $35 with tax. So if you can find it for the slightly discounted rate, I say by all means go for it, especially if you're looking to get the last Power Dasher of the set. But if you're looking to get the thing at full retail, yay, I'd say wait a little bit on this one because there's some quality control problems that might pop up. If this was at its full retail value, I would give this set about a solid 8 out of 10. There's some quality control problems with Impactor's thighs, and some of the joints feel kind of wonky on a couple of the other bots. But if you were buying this thing at a discounted rate, I'd say if you can find it for $50, it'd go up to about an 8.5 out of 10. It's not the greatest, most wonderful thing to come out of the Siege line, but it is a pretty good set that I enjoy immensely. And if you're looking for a stop-motion stump double from Mirage, you have to get this set. If you're looking for the third Power Dasher, you also have to get this set. If you're looking for the Decepticon version of Impactor, fuck you, you also have to get this set. So congratulations, Hasbro, you managed to grab me by the balls yet again and force me to cough up $80 on a 3-pack of characters I already have in slight repainted deviations. So anyways, this has been the Stop Motion Reviewer, and hopefully I should have Earthrise Prime by February 7th, and that's when I'll do my review on him.